Father Johnson was an old black man from a real proud race of men. When he was a child, he heard them tell of Butcher Creek, and the story was old even then. How the white man came and took over the land, and the blood of the black man mixed with white. But Grandfather Johnson was a full-blood man, proud of his people and their rights. Now Grandfather Johnson was a tribal man, he knew all the old hunting ways. He knew how to wield the mallet, throw the killer boomerang, and he'd entertain the tourists when they came. And Grandfather Johnson had a brand new suit, a new hat or his snowy-headed crown. But whenever the tourists were about to arrive, he would change into his old hand-me-down. When I asked the reason, he said, "Son, you ought to know, my old working clothes look better for the part. I'm just old Grandfather Johnson making boomerangs for sale. I'd lose business if I went round looking smart." So he sold them boomerangs, and he taught them to throw, and they bragged for months of seeing the real thing. When they'd gone, Grandpa dressed up, took his money from a bag, and smiled as he played cash for a new gold ring. He would always bail me up when we met in town, and he'd bite me for some money or a stone. Oh, but I can't forget the time I had to tell Grandfather I was sorry that I was stony broke. He just smiled and emptied out his pockets, the notes and the silver flowed apace. With a twinkle in his eye, he shoved the money in my hand and smiled at the look upon my face. Well, Grandfather Johnson died one year on Walkabout, in a strange land alone, in the dark. No one knew his name, or knew from where he came. They just found him dead one morning in the park. And they buried Grandfather Johnson as a pauper. It was months and months before I even knew. I gave his money to the hungry, his clothes to the poor, and his story I'm giving to you. And his story.